لا يزال الخير حيا لا يزال إن في الدنيا سلاما
و... My dear brothers and sisters in the deen, fathers as well as mothers, I first of all admonish myself standing before you and all of you to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. He called on you who believe, O you who believe. اتقوا الله حق تقاته. If fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he ought to be feared. ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. And do not die except in the state of Islam. أحبتي في الله. My dear beloved ones in the deen. آية في القرآن أردت أن أتدبر عليها. آية, a verse in the Quran which I would love all of us here to contemplate over this ayah. يقول الله تعالى, Allah says, واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله. Fear the day you shall return to your Lord, the day you will be returned to your Lord. ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. And every soul will be rewarded according to their deeds, what they've earned. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not treat them unjustly. إِنَّكُمْ أَيُّهَا الْأَحِبَّةِ تَرْجِعُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ. Indeed, you shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. رُجُوعًا يَعْقُبُهُ وَقُوفٌ طَوِيلٌ بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. We shall all return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Thereafter, we'll stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for over 50 years, 50,000 years, standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give account of everything you've done in this dunya. Allah says, إِلَيْهِ مَرْجِعُكُمْ جَمِيعًا. You shall all return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعَدُ اللَّهِ حَقًّا. This is a true promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّهُ يَبْدَأُ الْخَلْقَ ثُمَّ يُعِيدُهُ. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who originated your being here. Allah created you. And also as well, He will reproduce each and every one of us from our graves to give account yawm al-qiyamah. Allah said, لِيَجْزِيَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ بِالْقِسْطِ. So that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward those who believe in Him and do good deeds in a justice way. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. And for those who disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who reject faith, Allah says, لَهُمْ شَرَابٌ مِّنْ حَمِيمٌ. They will be given hot boiling water from Jahannam. وَعَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْفُرُونَ. And they shall receive painful punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because they reject faith. نعم إخوة الإسلام. Indeed, my dear brothers and sisters in the deen. لقد كتب الله تبارك وتعالى علينا الموت. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed death for all of us. الآية التي قرأتها آنفة. The ayah that I recited at the beginning of the khutbah where Allah says, وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. Fear the day you shall be returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's one phase of the ayah. And the other phase of the ayah, Allah said, ثُمَّ تُوَفَّى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَّا كَسَبَتْ وَهُمْ لَا يُظْلَمُونَ. Every soul will be rewarded accordingly. In justice. With justice, I mean. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward every soul. And He will not oppress or wrong anyone. Allah will reward you accordingly. So the first part is, I and all of you, myself, every being, every soul must taste the pain of death. Allah said, قُلْ say, إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْ فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ. The death that you run away from all the time. When you see the car coming, you run. When you see someone who is having, for example, let's say someone has knife, cutlass, etc., you run away from them. Why? Because you don't want to die. But however, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ, it will surely overtake you. You will die one day, ya akhi. You will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sooner or later. And Allah said, فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. That will approach you, will overtake you, and you will be returned to your Lord, your Creator, the one who knows the secret and the open, the unseen and the seen. Allah, you will meet Allah, and Allah will inform you about everything you did. أحبتي في الله إننا نعيش في غفلة. We are heedless. We are not contemplating at all as Muslims the way we're supposed to be. Today we see the dead. People talk about even football. The dead lying down, they're talking about football. The dead lying down, they're talking about the dunya. Their brother or sister who used to be with them is gone. But they're still talking about this dunya. And they're still following their desire. Subhanallah. Ya Akhi al-Kareem. When that day comes, Allah said, Kalla idha balagati taraqiya wa qila man raqa. When the moment comes, when death is about to overtake you, Allah said, the person lying down there will see, man raq. Please call the paramedics to resuscitate my brother, my sister, my aunt, my mother, my father. But Allah said, وَذَنَّ أَنَّهُ الْفِرَاقِ. But the person lying down there knows that today is my last day in this dunya. وَالْتَفَتِ السَّاقِ بِالسَّاقِ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ يَوْمَئِذٍ الْمَسَاقِ. And this leg would turn to the other leg and say, we shall rejoin again, meet again, يوم القيامة. That moment will come when they will carry you. The moment will come when you have no power, no strength anymore to wash your body, to take shower by yourself. But you'll be washed. That moment will come when you will speak no more. Everyone will talk about you. And you'll meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, I believe most or some of the Muslims are ready to wish everyone Happy New Year. Happy New Year. Probably the messages have started coming. To wish you Happy New Year. New Year. But what did you do? What did you achieve? Did you think about your purpose of being in this dunya? Did you ever think about your journey that you went back on very soon to meet Allah? عَامٌ قَدْ مَدَى. Indeed, the year has passed. ذَهَبَتْ سَاعَاتٌ وَأَيَامُهُ وَشُهُورُهُ. The days have gone. The hours, the month of this year is gone. It has all gone. أَفْرَاحُ وَأَحْزَانُ. All the happiness, the fortunes, the sadness, the grief you went through, all is gone. The whole year is gone. It will never come back. Wallahi, it will never come back. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يوم تجد كل نفس ما عملت من خير محضرا. The day when every soul will see its deed before them waiting.
It will be brought before you. وَمَا عَمِلَتْ مِنْ سُوءٍ. The good deeds and the bad deeds. This is where the evil person تَوَدُّلَ وَأَنَّ بَيْنَهَا وَبَيْنَهُ أَمَدًا بَعِيدًا. They would wish to have a distance between them. A very long distance between them and their deeds. But that's not going to happen. That's not going to happen, Ya Akhil Kareem. يوم تنشر الصحف وتوزن الأعمال. The day your books will be given to you and your deeds will be put on the scale. Allah will weigh them for you. Allah says in the Quran, وكل إنسان ألزمناه طائره في عنقه. Every man will be clinked with their book, their deeds, by their neck. ونخرج له يوم القيامة كتابا يقرأه منشور يقرأه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ونخرج له يوم القيامة كتابا يلقاه منشورا. And you'll be given your book that day. اقرأ كتابك. Allah will say, read your book. كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيبا. You're well sufficient to put your soul into accounts. And this is what we need to do now. Whenever the day passes by, think about yourself. Think about your journey. Think about what you've sent before you and what you left behind. Allah said, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نُحْيِي الْمَوْتَ وَنَكْتُبُ مَا قَدَّمُوا وَآثَارَهُمْ وَكُلَّ شَيْءٍ أَحْصَيْنَاهُ فِي إِمَامٍ مُبِينٍ. Allah said, I give life to the dead. When you die, Allah will give you life. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring you back. He will put you into account. And He will register everything you sent before and what you left behind. طُوبَ لِمَنْ مَاتْ وَمَاتَتْ مَعَهُ ذُنُوبُ. Blessed is the one who dies. Listen to these statements. Blessed is the one who dies and their sin die with them. Youngsters, young brothers and sisters, young adults, listen to these statements. Allah is warning you. Allah said, I give life to the dead and I will register everything you sent before and what you left behind. And here the statement goes, طُوبَ لِمَنْ مَاتْ وَمَاتَتْ مَعَهُ ذُنُوبُ. Blessed is the one who dies, and when they die, their sins die with them. They commit sin. The day they die, their sins finish. It does not continue after death. وَالْوَيْلُ الطَّوِيلُ لِمَنْ مَاتْ وَلَمْ تَمُتْ مَعَهُ ذُنُوبُ وَتَبْقَى ذُنُوبُهُ مِئَةَ عَامٍ وَهُوَ يُعَذَّ بِهَا أَوْ مِنْ أَجْلِهَا. Disaster for the person who dies. When they die, their sins did not die with them. Rather, it generates. Whenever they commit, someone followed that path, they initiated the evil path, the bid'ah, and etc. Whoever practices the same thing or the same act they initiated, they have the same reward in their graves. You don't want to be like them, do you? So it's time to take a U-turn. Make a U-turn now. Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Hassan al-Basri said, he said, Ya Ibn Adam, said, O you the son of Adam, إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ أَيَّام. Your days. كُلَّمَا ذَهَبَ الْيَوْم ذَهَبَ بَعْدُك. Whenever the day passes by, part of you is gone. It will never come back. May Allah forgive each and every one of us. May the brothers and sisters in the deen. Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu, he said that عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, the messenger of Allah, may the peace and blessings be upon him, said, لا تزول قدم عبد يوم القيامة حتى يسأل عن أربع. He said, a man will not take a step the day of judgment until he or she will be questioned about four things. When you come from your grave, I come from my grave. We'll be questioned about four things. The first one, an umrihi fima afna. He will be questioned about his life. How did he consume it? How did he consume your life? Your days, the month, the years, saying Happy New Year. What did you achieve there? What did you achieve that year Allah gave you? 10, 15, 20, all those years have gone, but what did you achieve? Have you improved your life in the deen? Did you? It's not a problem saying Happy New Year, wishing you. But what did you achieve here, akhi? So Allah will ask you about your life. How you consume it. وَعَنْ جَسَدِهِ فِيمَا أَبْلَاهِ Allah will ask you as well about your body. How did he, the person I mean, the servants, Allah will ask them about his body. How did he wear it out? And the next Allah is going to ask you, وَعَنْ مَالِ About your wealth. مِنْ أَيْنَ اكْتَسَبَ Where did you earn that wealth from? How did you get it? Halal way or haram way? And that's not the only question here. And also as well, Allah will ask you, وَفِيمَا أَنْفَقَ How did you spend it? Allah will ask you, how did you earn your wealth? And how did you spend it? وَعَنْ عِلْمِ مَاذَا عَمِلَ بِهِ About your knowledge, what did you do with it? My dear brothers and sisters, these are questions we need to prepare ourselves. But how can we prepare ourselves? It's to do good deeds. It's to utilize the time Allah has given us. That's why the Rasul ﷺ said, He said, نِعْمَتَانْ مَغْبُونٌ فِيهِمَا كَثِيرٌ مِنَ النَّاسِ He said, two precious ni'mah. Man misuse, abuse them. The first one is al-sihah, health. The health Allah gave you. You're healthy, sitting here, talking, mashallah, moving. Go to the hospital. Look at your brothers and sisters there. Wallahi, they could barely raise up their hands. They cannot drink on their own or by themselves. They're being fed through a tube. But here you are, you got all this ni'mah. Allah will ask you about this ni'mah yawm al-qiyamah. And also as well, wal-faraq, your free time. How did you make use of it? When you are free, what did you do? What do you do? May Allah make it easier for us. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. We thank Allah and the peace and blessings be upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ahibbati fillah, my dear brothers and sisters in the deen. Hasib nafsak qabla an tuhasab. Put your soul into account. Question yourself. Ask yourself over and over again. Before you are questioned yawm al-qiyamah. According to Bukhari, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ibn Abbas reported, he said that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he was advising a man. He said, اغتنم خمسة قبل خمس. Take advantage of five things before five. Take advantage of five before five. شبابك قبل حرامك. Take advantage of your youth before your old age.
Young ones, brothers and sisters, take advantage of your youth age now before you become old. You have to make use of it. Now you are strong, practice your deen. Now you are strong, read the Quran. Now you are strong, strive hard to do good deeds before old age comes. If you want to know about old age, ask the elderly. They will tell you. They will tell you. So take advantage of it. وَصِحَّتَكَ قَبْلَ سَقَمِكَ. Take advantage of your healthy life, your health, before you become ill or sick. Take advantage of it. وَغِنَاكَ قَبْلَ فَقْرِكَ. Take advantage of your wealth, the wealth Allah has given to you. Take advantage of it. Spend it in the cause of Allah before poverty overtake you. وَفَرَاغَكَ قَبْلَ شُغُلِكَ. Take advantage of your spare time, your free time. Read Quran. Stand in the night. Pray Salatul Qiyam. Come closer to Allah. By doing so, Allah will love you. And when Allah loves you, He be your eyes, He sees on your behalf. He touches on your behalf. And whatever you ask, Allah will give it to you. And finally, وحياتك قبل موتك. Take advantage of your life before death overtakes you. Now that you are alive, do more dhikr. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do more dhikr, ya akhil kareem. Glorify Allah. Say astaghfirullah. Say subhanallah al-azim, subhanallah wa bihamdi. All this will fill your skill. Do not engage in idle talks. No. Abstain from all evil acts. Abstain from backbiting. Destroying your brothers and sisters' image. Abstain from all this. And give more sadaqah. Rather, wishing people Happy New Year, then think about yourself. And ask yourself, what have I achieved? If you have achieved the best of this dunya, you think you're going to go to Al-Jannah, then khalas, sleep. But there is no guarantee. So therefore, you have to keep on walking more and more. Keep doing the job. May Allah forgive each and every one of us. Many brothers and sisters in the deen, before I leave this podium, I want to extend our gratitude to each and every one of you for helping the community to have a good atmosphere where we are today and to look after the masjid. We know the masjid is the masjid of Allah. Allah said, وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. The mosque belongs to Allah. Do not invoke or call upon anyone except Allah. Only Allah. Only Allah. So we have to make sure we look after the masjid. We need your help. Whichever way, or whatever way. Now, the calendar is printed. We printed the calendar. The masjid paid for it. Alhamdulillah, it's 1,500. But we said, we're not selling. In the masjid, we are not allowed to sell. It's haram. Not to bargain. You are not allowed to do it. The Rasulullah said, if you see someone selling in the masjid, say, may Allah curse his or her business or trade. It's not allowed. The masjid is a sacred place. It's just dhikr, remembrance of Allah. What we do, we ask brothers and sisters to donate towards the calendar. At least £5, £10 or more, if you can. Just for us to get the money back to put it in the kufa, inshallah. So we are asking you, the brothers and sisters, they're all over. They have the calendar. Whatever contribution you have, give it towards this calendar and take it, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive each and every one of us. Allahumma ighfir lana warhamna wasturna wa'fu 'anna wa tajawwaz 'an sayyi'atina wa tawaffana ma'al abrar. Allahumma ya Allah tub 'alaina tawbatan nasuha. Allahumma waffiqna fima tuhibbu wa tarda. Rabbana la taj'alna fi maqamina hadha dhanban illa ghafarta wa la 'ayban illa satarta wa la hamman illa faradta wa la daynan illa qadayta wa la maridan illa shafaita wa la dhulla minna illa hadayta. Nas'aluka ya Allah an tarfa' maktaka wa ghadabaka 'anna wa la tu'akhidhna bima fa'alna ya Allah wa la أخذنا بما فعل سفه منا. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات يوم يقوم الحساب. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب نار. وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد وآخر دعوان الحمد لله رب العالمين. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.